All right, well, moving on. It's a power everyone wants to have at one point or another. Wouldn't it be good to read people's minds and really know what's going on? Well, we don't really have that power, but we've called someone in.
Yeah, Janine Driver's here, and she is a body language expert and the New York Times bestselling author of You Say More Than You Think. And she's going to show us just how to read someone. You say we can read someone in 6 seconds or less?
Just glance at them and size them up? Maybe we should time her when we throw these pictures here.
Well, I can. And it's also not only reading someone, it's you can make a change in less than 6 seconds. So if you're looking for a job, you're looking to have a date 6 nights a week if you want, it only takes 6 seconds. If you
That's a lot of work, 6 nights a week.
We're going to talk about the celebs and the Emmys, and we're going to talk about what can you learn from their body language.
Okay, well, let's throw up some pictures here. We've compiled some very familiar faces here. I've got the pictures here. There's my Dr. Oz.
So Dr. Oz, I love Dr. Oz. I'm on his show about once a month. He's one of my favorite celebs that are out there. He's the real deal. If you see here, he has his palm out. He's very expressive, and right here he has both hands are out. If you can see his left and right, this is what I call a basketball steeple. Steepling is like this, like we see in The Simpsons, Smithers, or Donald Trump does the steeple. This is power, authority, and confidence. When you explode it like this, this is called the basketball steeple. It's power, authority, and confidence with heart and passion. Who does this? Obama, when he's talking about the economy, when he talks about the car industry and how we want to turn it around. This is one of his go-to moves. Who else? There was an old detective. You guys may remember at the end of the case, be like, I got to ask you one more question. Columbo. So Columbo, it's that likability, but it's
Dr.
power.
Oz in that picture doesn't even look like him because he has such a grimace on his face. This might be going well, but you know, he's probably talking about a photo
is we have to be careful on adding meaning where it doesn't belong. I call that the old body language. We can see body language, but you don't know what's causing it. So he's in a little still moment. We don't exactly know what's going on. One of Dr. Oz's favorite moves is this. This is a handgun steeple.
It's
very dangerous to point it to someone. Imagine if I'm like, good point. I'm glad you brought that up.
Yeah.
But what he'll do is Dr. Oz will have his feet down, and he'll point it to the ground. So when I talk to him, I say, Dr. Oz, you can use the handgun steeple as long as you keep it down. And he does. He keeps it down. He never points it to the audience. In boardrooms across America, you'll see this. Kiss of death on a job interview. Never sit like this and say, I'm so glad you asked me that question. I'd like to tell you about my last position. You've just killed all chances of getting the job.
Wow.
It's way too aggressive.
Yes.
But you don't want to be so timid either that you kind of look like
this. No,
this
is a great move on a job interview.
Listen,
I'd love to tell you a little bit about what I've done and my accomplishments and how it can help your company grow.
Let's take a look at Rachel Ray, because I think you were talking, that was going to come up first, but here we are.
Yeah, Rachel Ray.
Let's think about her.
Yeah, so you ladies have skirts on. You can't do this figure four position. This is called the figure four. If you look at it, it looks like the number four coming up. The figure four, look, it kind of creates an arrow pointing to what I call the naughty bits right there, which is, it's just confidence. There's a sexuality with body language.
I've never heard someone describe it just like that. I'm going to pick up that lingo.
You don't want the bits in lockdown. You don't want, if you're in a job interview, the papers on your lap or your coat across you or the pocketbook. You actually want to have your feet put aside. This is a male-dominated pose. If you're in Europe, they'll know you're from the States. Powerful women do the figure four now, like Rachel Ray. Oprah Winfrey can be seen doing it. Ellen DeGeneres could be seen doing it. It's a powerful move that comes from the States.
Uh-huh.
And what it does is it takes up space. It's as if I peed in the perimeter and I've just marked my territory.
You marked it.
You're wondering what that was. Not tequila.
Right.
That was me peeing in the perimeter.
Now we know.
What about the arm that she had up? Was that another figure
Super
four?
Super confidence. No, the more space you take up, the more confident you appear. This is dynamite. I call this the shoulder pop. You're popping your shoulder and elbow back over the chair. Watch the difference, right? Follow my lane. We do this, Mel. We fold our hands. This is very passive. This is how people sit on The Apprentice before they're fired by Donald Trump.
There you go.
Why would you sit that way on a job interview or a date? Instead, pop it. Ready? Pop. Look at this. Look at us.
We look so casual.
Super casual.
Right.
All right, let's move on to this. I was going to say a couple. They're not really a couple. Barbara Walters and Senator John McCain.
Well,
she looks like she's scolding him. Johnny, don't ever say that.
Definitely a scolding gesture. She's got the finger point. Also, she has her arm crossed her midsection. We have our three power zones, which are our neck dimple, our belly button, and, of course, the bits. We keep them open and we're confident. But she's blocking her center mass here. You know, I saw backstage, you guys have an Energizer bunny, and he's got a big drum in the middle of his body.
Yeah.
That's a shield. What she's done here is doing this Energizer Bunny move where she's blocking her midsection.
Maybe she just has cramps.
She's pointing. And here's the other thing. Her belly button.
She's too old for cramps. Yeah. Never mind. Take that back.
Yeah, like 30 years too old for cramps. But she's got her belly button facing away from him, giving him what I call the cold shoulder. Ooh. Literally, her shoulder's facing them. When we talk to people we like, admire, and trust, our belly button faces towards them, not away. So be careful on a job interview or a date when you say, hi, thanks, so nice to meet you, cold shoulder. Instead, belly button should be here. Hi, I want to thank you so much for bringing me in.
So kind of face
your belly button.
Yeah.
Yes.
What about John McCain, who was, I think he had his arms crossed in front of him as
So he has a wall, but he's taking up space where she's getting small. Women, when we're insecure, angry, we actually will take less space. When the elevator gets crowded, the woman's the first person to move her purse in front of her, where guys are like, I don't think so. Like, guys will take up space. He's still taking up space.
Gotcha.
Take up space, even when you're nervous.
Let's try to get this one in. Regis and Kelly, you see them everywhere. Let's look at this snapshot of them. Regis?
Oh, so they're in sync. Look at the belly button rule. Belly buttons facing each other, if you can see that. The belly buttons are angled towards each other. And we face towards people we like, admire, and trust. They're actually giving the camera a little bit of the cold shoulder, but their belly button and the core of the body are facing them. If you're at a bar and the guy's asking you for a drink, and the guy, you say no, and the guy's like, I don't understand. She flirted with me all night. Well, guess what? Her belly button was facing George Clooney. She was talking to you because you're the other friend in the bar, but her belly button was going home with George. Not with you, my dear.
We want to get one more in. The View girls.
The View girls. All right, so let's say The View. All right, these girls are in sync. If you look, Barbara Walters, of course, the middle person is seen as the powerful person. If you're shy or introverted and you're watching at home, you don't have to be the chatterboxes. Let your chatterbox friends stand on the outside. Stand in the middle. You'll be perceived as a leader and a powerful person.
Well, they're all touching. Everyone's touching somebody.
Right. We touch people that we like. And be careful with touches. You don't want to do those Elaine from Seinfeld heavy-handed hits where it's like, shut up. A nice firm touch says that you're important to me. With the amount of pressure you would be ironing, you know, a piece of clothing. And I have to say, I have to get in what's Ellen DeGeneres.
Ellen,
one of the things she does is she always has her guests sitting to her right, but she loves to cross her right leg on top of her left. So it almost comes across that she's giving a wall between her and her guest. Uh-huh. It's not the case. And a lot of these old body language books will say, yes, she doesn't like the guest, really? Because even with Portia, her wife, she'll often sit this way. This is her comfortable pose.
Well,
her
it
right
could also be the
left.
Way the camera gets her, too. We have a camera right there that's getting her.
Well, look at the difference, though.
Up to
it's the
audience.
Leg. So typically, we cross the outside leg. This is a closed circle. You're not. Right. You should not buy us a drink right now. We're saying we're a closed circle. This is how Ronald Reagan and Nancy Reagan sat all the time.
Oh, wow.
This is interesting. This is just what I call Ellen's baseline. Don't read too much into body language. Know what the power moves are. Use them. Be cautious, because people are mind reading.
Janine, thank you. We got to go.
Size
we'll
it
right
up.
After this.
Thank you, Janine.